This is the third video in the series of videos looking at Fan Xian's poetry reciting in the drama Joy of Life, 庆余年. In the previous two videos in this series, we've looked at 6 poems in total. Today, I'm going to introduce you to 3 more poems. And they also share a common theme, which is 国仇家恨. In the long history of China, there are many dynasties that took over other previous dynasties. Many poems that have survived till today that are about those not so nice things about life. And in Fan Xian's display of Chinese literature history, he recited many poems, many well-known poems within this genre. So today I'm going to introduce you to 3 poems as such, and in reverse chronicle orders, because why not? The first poem is written at the end, very end of Song Dynasty, already turning into Yuan Dynasty. And then the second poem goes back in time, on the brink of shifting between 五代十国and Song Dynasty. And then further back to an extremely turbulent time in mid-late Tang Dynasty. And they're written by 3 people who have very different social positions. One of them is a high official, one of them is a disposed ruler, and then another one is a commoner. And those 3 poems are 过零丁洋, 春望, and 虞美人. First, let's look at the poem 过零丁洋, written by the Southern Song Dynasty poet and also a high official, Wen Tianxiang. Wen Tianxiang is very well known because he's a high official of Song Dynasty. He got to his position purely by his talent, going through the official civil exam, ending up being the top one. So he's like the best student of his year in the entire country. And he became actually a commander of battles and of wars against the Yuan Dynasty, the Mongolian invaders. And eventually his country was lost and China went under the rule of the Mongolians. He refused to surrender. And then he was executed because of that. And he has written many poems during his captivity to state he is never going to surrender. 过零丁洋 is his most famous poem. Let me first recite that to you, and then we're gonna look at it line by line. 辛苦遭逢起一经，干戈寥落四周星。山河破碎风飘絮，身世浮沉雨打萍。惶恐滩头说惶恐，零丁洋里叹零丁。人生自古谁无死，留取丹心照汗青。文天祥 wrote this poem in the very traditional Shi form. It's not necessarily in the Song Dynasty Ci, the dominant Song style poetry. And the last line, 人生自古谁无死，留取丹心照汗青, is known to every Chinese. If you say the first half of the line to a Chinese person, 99.9% of the chances that person is gonna reply the next half. It is that well known. 辛苦遭逢起一经. This line is not that easy to understand unless you actually look at his life story. 辛苦 means hard work. For example, you work a whole day, you feel very exhausted, physically demanding job, and you can say you're very 辛苦. 遭逢 means encounter, but it's encountering things that are not desirable or not so good. 起一经, starting with one. 经 is classics. So what he's saying is his very difficult experiences in his life all actually started with learning classics, because he learned classics and then he went to exams and then he became an official and then he got the task of defending his country and then he's captured. So all his hardship in his life started with him learning stuff. At the time when Wen Tianxiang wrote this poem, he is being captured by the Yuan Dynasty soldiers and he's trapped on a ship that is traveling across the water called Ling Ding Yang. That's why the title of this poem is called 过零丁洋, Passing Ling Ding Yang. 干戈寥落四周星. 干戈 means war. 寥落 means the state of desolation, hopelessness. 四周星 means 4 years. This is a very particular way of talking about 4 years that you don't really see very often. But here, this line just means he's been at war for 4 years. 山河破碎风飘絮. The country is broken and it's like the willow seed that is being blown in the wind. 山河, mountain and river. This word often is used to represent a physical existence of a country because it has rivers and mountains and its geological presence. 破碎 broken, shattered. 风 wind, 飘 flow. 絮 is the fluff. And if you have willows around where you live, you know in spring how their seed looks like fluff balls flying in the wind. So he's saying the fate of the country is on the brink of just total destruction. It's been blown by the wind. It has no control of itself. It's been pushed by fate. 身世浮沉雨打萍身世 is a person's own experience. Whatever you've gone through in life is called your 身世浮沉浮 means float, 沉 means sink. 雨打萍雨 rain, 打 hit. 萍 is a type of aquatic plant that usually floats on top of water. So when a country is in great state of uncertainty and war, as individuals, your ups and downs are like the aquatic plant that's been beaten by rain. So again, you are very much out of control of your own fate. So the first four lines are describing what he has gone through personally. 惶恐滩头说惶恐伶仃洋里叹伶仃 This long line is a great example of Chinese poetry's serendipity that heavily depends on the language's nature itself and just lucky coincidence. 惶恐滩头说惶恐 At the rapids, that's called 惶恐 I talk about being afraid. So what happened is, historically, because he was leading wars and battles, there was a great defeat that he suffered that happened at this place called 惶恐 Rapids. This rapids was initially named 黄公滩黄公 Rapids, but because it sounded very much like 惶恐 the word, so often people call it 黄恐滩黄恐 Rapids. 惶恐 as a word means being afraid.Been worrying about something. You're not settled, you're extremely anxious. So in the first line, it's a really lucky coincidence that the place that he was defeated at is named Fear Rapids. At this Fear Rapids, 说惶恐, talk about being afraid. And then the second line, 伶仃洋里叹伶仃, it's another great coincidence that when he wrote this poem, he's on a ship,And he's actually traveling across the water that's at Pearl River. It's a southern Chinese river, a major river. And that place is called 伶仃洋. But 伶仃 as a word itself means being alone, being the single one. So 伶仃洋里, inside 伶仃洋, 叹伶仃, exclaim, talk about being alone. So this line is at a scary,Frightening rapids, talk about being frightened, and then over the loneliness ocean, talking about being alone. It's a very lucky strike that it happens to be there are two real places named like that, and it absolutely fits his emotion and his personal experience. This line is very well known, but it's also a line that cannot really be quoted to other situations because it's super specific. Then the last line of this poem is the most famous line in Chinese poetry, talking about being loyal to your own country. 人生自古谁无死留取丹心照汗青人 human, 生 life. So as a person being alive, 自古 means since ancient.Literal meaning. As a word, it means since the beginning of time. 自古 is the state of something having always been like something. 谁无死谁 who 无 not having 死 death. So the line means who in history can avoid death. 留取丹心照汗青留 means keep 取 means take. I'll take something and keep it here. So what do you want to keep? 丹心丹 means red. 心 means heart.As a word, 丹心 means that red, glowing heart of loyalty that has no blemishes. 照汗青照 means shining a light on something. 汗青汗 means sweat, 青 means blue. But 汗青 here means the ancient bamboo scroll. Before paper was invented, China used to have books that are all made of bamboo, when you are using that material to serve as a book, when the humidity is not correct, it will have beads of water on it. So often you'll get sweating from this type of books. So the word 汗青 means scrolls. So basically he's saying, I'll keep my loyal heart and leave it on a historical book. Because everybody dies eventually, I'd rather die and to be remembered as a brave and loyal person. 人生自古谁无死，留取丹心照汗青 is really the most famous line declaring a person's loyalty. And I would encourage you to remember it and then test it on your Chinese friends, and you'll understand what I mean by everybody knows what's the second half of the line.Now, let's move back in time and looking at the second poem. This poem was written at the very, very beginning of Song Dynasty. So after Tang Dynasty ended, there was about a good half of the 10th century in China where the country is broken into many different powers, similar to what you see in South and North Dynasty that's called Wu Dai Shi Guo. At the very end of this is when Song Dynasty came up and then took over and reigned China as a whole again. This poem happened right at the beginning of Song and at the end of the chaotic era, and it's written by the deposed ruler of one of those small powers during that period called Nan Tang, Southern Tang. And the deposed ruler is named Li Yu. So he's often called Nan Tang Hou Zhu, Southern Tang latest ruler. He had his capital in today's Nanjing, and he was defeated by the Song Dynasty soldiers. He surrendered his city and gave up his title. Then he was captured and moved to Song Dynasty's capital, and he lived there for quite a while before he was poisoned. And this poem, Yu Meizhen, as history has recorded, was written on the evening before he was poisoned. Li Yu is a very famous person now in China's history, in literature history especially, because obviously of his identity as a ruler of a power that's dying and died, and he kind of died with it. But also because he's an unusually talented man. He's great at calligraphy, painting, music, obviously poetry writing. He's such a great artist who just happened to be also a member of the unlucky royal family. Yu Meiren is its 词牌, also its 曲牌, because this is at the transition period between Wu Dai Shi Guo and Song Dynasty. So Song 词, Song's poem, hasn't been completely settled down yet in terms of its format. And at that time already, there are Tang 曲, so Tang Dynasty's kind of songs. So Yu Meiren is originally a Tang Dynasty song that later in Song Dynasty got solidified as a 词牌. So you can say this is Song 词. You can also say it's Tang 曲. I mean, you can decide whatever it's called because it's written by a person who most people would recognize as still belonging to the inherited Tang Dynasty. So Yu Meiren is its 词牌, and then its subtitle doesn't have one, actually. So they use the first line of this poem to work as its subtitle, which is 春花秋月何时了. Let me recite this poem to you first. 春花秋月何时了，往事知多少，小楼昨夜又东风，故国不堪回首月明中。雕栏玉砌应犹在，只是朱颜改。问君能有几多愁，恰似一江春水向东流。If you're tonal sensitive, you can tell it's a two-parted 词 as well, like most 宋词 are. So let's go through it line by line.
春花秋月何时了？春花 spring flower, 秋月 autumn moon.
春花秋月 together means the enjoyment of life, the beautiful views, the things that are seasonal, the celebrations, leisure of the world. So it's very weird. Why does he talk about that when he is like, you know, a person who is pretty depressed? Well, let's see what happens.
何时了?
何? What? When? It's a question word that signals you're asking.
时 time, 了, finish.
So now it gets interesting. He's basically saying the enjoyment, the leisure, the nice things about life, when does it end? He's like, I've had enough of all this pointless enjoyment of life. When would it end?
往事知多少?
往事, past things, past events. He is a person who is at the end of his life, and he's had a great life. He's been the ruler.He's been a great artist. He also was an unlucky person who lost his country. So he has experienced a lot in his life. He's saying all those things that's in the past.
知多少
Know how much. So he's also like a person questioning, what do you know? You know, like if you are the reader, do you know what I've experienced in my life? That much stuff.
小楼昨夜又东风小楼
small building. So it could be the small building that he's living in at the moment.
昨夜 last night. 又
again,
东风
east wind. Last night, the east wind has blown through my small building again. So while he is losing hope and losing basically the will to keep living, the east wind is still blowing through his place. It's still a good season, as if world is gonna continue going on and regardless of how he feels.
故国不堪回首月明中
故 means something that has gone by, that used to be. For example,
故乡
means your hometown. So you often are not in that place anymore and you're thinking back at your hometown.
故人 means somebody you used to know.
So 故国国 is country. So the country that he used to have, now he has lost.
不堪回首
cannot bear, 回 turn around, 首 head. He can't bear to turn his head around and look at his bygone country.
月明中
moon bright inside. He's looking at the bright moon and he can't bear to think back at his lost country.
雕栏玉砌应犹在雕
carved 栏
fence 玉砌
jade steps. So these four characters are used to represent palaces, the palaces that he used to live in, that is heavily decorated, that's made with expensive material.
应犹在
should still be there. The poet now is in a different place from his home, his lost city, his lost country, and he's thinking that palace that he used to live in, that he used to own, should still be there.
只是朱颜改
But the only change, the only thing is
朱颜改
朱 red, 颜 face appearance. 朱颜 as a word means young girls, pretty women. 改 means change. So he's saying that old palace, that heavily decorated palace, should still be there. But the people have changed. The girls, the palace's maids, have all grown older. Maybe that place is still there, but the people who are working there, serving there, are different. Then, the last line, the most famous line in this poem.
问君能有几多愁恰似一江春水向东流
First part,
问君能有几多愁
Ask, 君 If you still remember, I've talked about this character a lot. It means respectful terms to the person that you're addressing. But here, it could also mean the poet is actually referring to himself as 君 So 问君 can be explained as, if you ask me,
能有
can
have
几多
how much
愁 sadness. If you ask me how much pain, how much sadness I can have,
恰似一江春水向东流
It's just like
恰似一江春水
A river of spring water
向东流
Towards east flows. So the line means, if you ask me how much pain, how much sadness I have, well, it's exactly likeA spring river that's flowing to the east. The reason that this line becomes so famous in Chinese literature history is because previously not many people are writing sadness in that way. Often they tend to describe the pain in a very detailed, specific way. Whereas spring river water flowing to the east, what does it mean exactly? It's not specific and it almost doesn't feel sad. But if you know who he is and what kind of experience he's gone through, it's not hard to imagine how much sadness he has. If you're curious about what I feel, look at the river, go figure it yourself. And in a very funny and ironic way, because he was not being very specific about his sadness, it somehow ended up being even sadder. So this is also a line that is so well known to every Chinese person. You can test your Chinese friend with this too. Just say,
问君能有几多愁
And they probably 99% of the time will say,
恰似一江春水向东流
Now let's move on to the third poem. Written chronologically even earlier, during Tang Dynasty, by none other than one of the greatest poets in Chinese history, 杜甫. This poem is called 春望, Spring Wish, or Spring Looking at Something, because Wang is a multiple meaning character. 杜甫 is called 诗圣, the saint of poetry. As opposed to Li Bai, it's called 诗仙, the god of poetry. 杜甫 has many poems left.Till today, thousands of them. So very well recorded, good for that. And his poems, compared to Li Bai, are considered to be the poems that are very grounded, that are very heavy. 杜甫's poetry often look at the very difficult living conditions of people at the time. This is heavily related to the fact that he was born at that time when he went through an extremely turbulent historical period in Tang Dynasty. If you've watched Legend of Demon Cat, it features An Shi Zhi Luan, the big revolt coming from An Lu Shan and Shi Si Ming during Tang Dynasty. And that caused Yang Guifei and Tang Xuanzong's epic love story. In the previous video, I talked about Chang Heng Ge, so everything is connected. 杜甫 wrote this poem right after An Shi Zhi Luan. The capital Chang'an was totally devastated. People escaped the city. The emperor escaped the city. And the city that used to be the greatest city at the time in the world, that's super populated, metropolitan, in the ancient times standard, now is like a wasteland. And he went into the city looking at what's going on there and feeling depressed, sad, angry about the destruction of the prosperities that Tang used to have. So let me first recite it for you.
国破山河在，城春草木深。感时花溅泪，恨别鸟惊心。烽火连三月，家书抵万金。白头搔更短，浑欲不胜簪。国破山河在。
If you've paid attention to my previous two videos and this video, you kind of already know what this line means. Because all those characters are repeated from previous poems.
国, country, 破, broken. 山河,
mountain river, here represents the physical existence of a country, the geological presence. 在 means being present, exist.
国破,
the country is broken because of the revolt, because of the battles, because of the war.
山河在。
But the mountains and rivers are still here.
城春草木深
城, city. Here it refers to none other than the greatest capital of that time, 长安.
春, spring. 草木
grass, tree.
深, deep.
Spring has come into 长安 city. And because people have escaped and it has gone through war, so it's not being maintained very well. You can see the trees and grass growing everywhere. It's becoming a wilderness-invaded capital.
感时花溅泪
感, feel, sense, 时, time. 花 flower, 溅泪 splash, tears. It means when you have feelings as a person, even if you just look at a flower, you start to cry. The nature doesn't really understand what the human emotion is, so it keeps going on, it continues. But as a person, when you have gone through such devastating events, you look at the flower and you start to cry.
恨别鸟惊心
恨, hate, 别 separation, departure
鸟
bird,
惊
startle, scare,
心 heart.
As a person, you hate separation, you hate seeing people off. In this type of environment, you may never see them again. So, when you have to part with somebody, the bird just cries randomly. The bird doesn't understand what human feels. But that unintentional bird's cry scares you.
So, 感时花溅泪恨别鸟惊心
are two extremely famous lines in Chinese literature history. It's used to describe when a person has a lot of emotion, they would put meaning into whatever they see in nature.
烽火连三月
烽火 the signal fire. If you know a little bit about Chinese Great Wall, they would have signal fire every how many miles. And when a big event, like an invasion happens, they will lit the fire and see the smoke. And the next stop sees the smoke, they pass it on. So 烽火 is that type of fire. It represents war. So basically means war has happened.
连
continuous, connect.
三月 3 months.
So the war has been happening for 3 months.
家书抵万金
家 home, 书, letter. So 家书 means a letter that you write home, 第一 Here means it can match, it can equal 万金 10,000 gold. So when war is happening, a letter that somebody writes home is worth 10,000 gold.烽火连三月家书抵万金 This long line is also extremely famous. Something that everybody knows what's the second line if you mention the first half. Then the final line. 白头搔更短 白 white 头 head 搔 means scratch 更 even more 短 short. So here it means the poet is already old.And his hair is already white, and he's losing his hair. Because of this situation is so depressing, he's under a lot of negative emotion, and when he scratches his head, his hair becomes even less.
浑欲不胜簪
Almost, want to, not. 胜 means being able to take something. 簪 is the hairpin.So because he's losing so much hair that it's almost like his hair cannot take the hairpin, there isn't that much hair left for a pin to be able to stay on his head. So this poem describes that extremely depressing, sad, worrying, anxious, hopelessness kind of feeling. When you see the great prosperities that you used to experience, you used to live in, gets totally destroyed.Those middle two lines,
感时花溅泪，恨别鸟惊心，烽火连三月，家书抵万金
are just so well known. Again, you can test all your Chinese friends. And I bet most of them will be able to answer the second half. So today, I've taken you through three very difficult to swallow, beautiful, but filled with not so great emotions, Chinese poems that have been mentioned by Fan Xian in the drama Joy of Life, 庆余年。I hope this video has been helpful to you also, the previous two, and I think I'll make another one that probably will have lighter themes. And I guess if you ever decided to go into the deep sea of learning Chinese literature, and one day you want to test how good you have become, you can watch that scene yourself and try to figure out what are all the poems that he managed to recite. Thank you for watching Avenue X. I'll see you in my next video. Meanwhile, live long and happy drama watching.